Anouk. You have quite a crowd over here. Ah. Wow. Anouk. Thank you, thank you. Anouk, you were at the very end before we found out that you actually qualified for the final. You were sitting, waiting for this decision. What went through your head? What are you thinking?
I don't know. It's maybe it sounds a little bit arrogant, but I wasn't worried. But when number 9 came, I was like, nah, no way, really. Oh my gosh, baby, it's not. And then I thought, oh, that's kind of weird. But I saw these camera people already like twice or three times, you know, walking along. And I was like, oh, I don't know. Why are they just, you know, checking me? And I thought, well, maybe there's a slight chance. And there they were. Yeah, I'm happy.
Well, congratulations to you too, of course. And Emily Sikkinge, you're the head of a delegation from the Netherlands. Did you expect this?
Of course.
Of course. Let's take a question from the Netherlands.
Hi Anouk, I'm Jens from RTV, Belgium. Congratulations.
Hi. Yeah, thank you.
You know, Eurovision has a lot of gay viewers. And you are a gay icon in Belgium and the Netherlands. Is it important to be a gay icon in this competition to win it?
No, I don't think so. I'm just here, you know, whether, if people are gay or not, I'm just here to perform my song as good as possible. I play for people.
Okay, thank you.
International media?
Well, that was the Belgian media. This is the Dutch media. Novum Nieuws. Thank you very much. Thank you. Anouk, last week you performed in front of an empty hall. And tonight it was...
empty hall?
Well, it was without any people.
Empty arena.
Oh. An empty arena. Hall. What were you thinking, lady?
Yeah, okay.
But now you had all the audience, many, many people. How much energy do you get from all the people watching you?
A lot, because I noticed, I was quite nervous, of course. But I thought it was amazing that the moment the chorus came in, that everybody was like waving their flags, and it was awesome. That felt really good, yeah.
Thank you.